the second graders from good old ParkView.
When we leave the school in 2 more years, we will miss it more and more.
But we'll be back as seniors in 2024.
We'll keep those 3 R's intact and keep that pledge real close.
Respectful, responsible, reliable are some things that matter most.
This is a note for our kids selves to our older selves.
But for now, we'll read to you.
Sit back, relax, and enjoy. Take a note or two.
Do you remember being young, 6, 7, 8, or 9?
Anything was possible, any moment, any time.
You could turn your baby blanket into a cape to fly.
Or close your eyes and reappear in a castle in the sky.
Put your mind to it, son, and it can happen. These are words you did believe.
It didn't matter the task, it didn't matter the work. You knew you could achieve.
Then a few but short years went by, your dreams were rearranging.
No time for this, no time for that. Imagination started changing.
You had ideas that could have worked, that you allowed to just slip through.
Then 10 years down the line, some other guy made it happen instead of you.
He made millions, retired young. How come him? Why not you?
He kept the heart of a child, believed dreams, they can come true.
If I could tell my future self some words to hold real close.
There's never enough time, there's never enough money, and that's just how it goes.
So make some time to smell the flowers and sing your music loud.
And laugh and joke and keep friends close and make your kid self proud.
I'm saying this now for when I watch this, then maybe graduation day.
You can do it! Make it happen! Where there's a will, there's a way.
Ask yourself, seriously?
If I was still a kid, would I then believe?
And now, an awesome book written by Dallas Clayton and read to you by some of your favorite second graders.
There's places in the world where people don't dream.
A rock, a power unicorn, a candy cane machine.
Of magical watermelon boats and musical baboons.
Of teeny tiny trumpet players training pet raccoons.
Yes, there are places in this world where people dream up dreams.
So simply and fantastical and practical they seem.
To lose all possibility of thinking super things.
Of dancing wild animals with diamond-coated wings.
Instead, they dream of furniture, of buying a new hat.
Of ornamenting silverware, could you imagine that?
Instead, they lie awake at night wishing for a car.
Not one that runs on jelly beans, but one that's regular.
They dream of breakfast sandwiches. They dream of cell phones.
Sometimes I even dream of dreams that aren't even their own.
Yes, there are places in the world where dreams are almost dead.
So please, my child, do keep in mind before you go to bed.
To dream a dream as big could ever dream to be.
Then dream a dream 10 times as big as that one you see.
Then once you've got that dream in mind, please dream a million more.
And not a million quiet dreams, but a million dreams that roar!
A million dreams so loud they scream, so loud they sing and shout!
So super huge they say, hey world, guess what I'm dreaming about?
I'm dreaming about everything that no one thought to wonder.
Dreams so big! That they've got dreams, and they got dreams up under.
Please dream for those who've given up, for those who've never tried.
Please use your dreams to make new dreams for all the dreams that died.
Because you're the one whose dreams can be whatever dreams you want.
Whose dreams can change the way things are and the way that things are not.
And if they say that all your dreams are too big to come true,
you tell them what I told you. That's what dreams are meant to do.
They're meant to make you seem as if you don't know up from down.
Because dreams are dreams,
And that's why dreams are worth having around.
So when you think your dreaming's done, just remember what I said.
Close your eyes, my child, and dream a perfect dream inside your head.